In our last video, I talked about the importance of rewarding yourself, making yourself feel good for the short-term wins that you've had. Have you been doing that? If you have, great. If you haven't, do it today. Make sure that you take a moment or two today to just think about, what have I done? What good things have I done? And make yourself feel good. Now, have you had any challenges show up? Have you had any disappointments? Have you been on track and then maybe done something that you shouldn't have done, right? That pulled you back into your old behavior? If that hasn't happened for you yet, I have one guarantee, it will, right? You're gonna fall back potentially on your behavior, you're gonna have a disappointment. Look, that's part of the process. And there's a reason why it happens. And I believe that reason is that it's good for you. It's what you need. Does it feel good when you know that you didn't do what you were supposed to do, what you wanted to do? Heck no. Does it feel good when you get disappointed? You work really hard and something doesn't work out the way you wanted to? Not usually. It doesn't feel good initially. But I want you to start thinking about those things differently. They're what you need. Now, I know you would much prefer to have everything work in a straight, linear process. I'm progressing, I'm progressing, I'm progressing. This is feeling good. But that's not real life. That's not the way it works. You make some progress, you have a little challenge shows up. Well, what is that challenge for? Whether it's disappointment or a setback or you not following through, it's there to help you. That's why it's there. It's there to help you get stronger. I remember one time I set this goal. For 3 months, I was going to earn an additional X amount of money. It was a pretty significant amount over what I already had scheduled for that 3 month period. And so I started off and I did outcome 4-3-2-1. I had myself in the right mindset. And I said, I'm going to make myself create it. And I wasn't taking frantic action. I wasn't like, you know, all in a frenzy trying to create this amount of business. But I just was so focused. I was making the right connections and things were just happening. And it was great. I was off to a good start. And then I got this call that was phenomenal news. One of my biggest clients wanted to book me over in Europe for a couple of weeks, and it was going to be in excess of over, I think it was $150,000, close to $200,000 for all the things that they wanted me to do over there. And I said, yeah, this is going to help me achieve my goal. This is great. And I sent in the proposal and they bought off on it, and then it fell apart. The event didn't happen. And I remember being crushed because, oh no, my goal, now I'm not going to reach it. And that lasted for a few minutes and I was really down. And I don't get down very often, but I remember feeling down because I felt it slipped away from me. Maybe there's something I could have done that I didn't do. And then I remembered what I'm sharing with you. Maybe this is what I need. Maybe this is the perfect thing to happen. And I started changing my mindset. I used cancel thought, right? I got rid of this feeling I didn't want, these thoughts I didn't want. I got back on my outcome 4-3-2-1. And literally, I did it within probably about 10 minutes. I let myself sulk for about 10 minutes after losing a couple hundred grand of what, or not losing, I never had it, right? But the potential. And then I got back on track. And again, I didn't get in a frenzy, but I just kept taking effective action, elegant action. And then I remember 2 weeks before the 3 month period was up, I said, you know, let me just check on things because I'd just kind of been letting it happen. And I wasn't diligently following every development of new business that was coming. And I realized I had surpassed my goal. This goal that I thought, which was a challenging goal, that I thought there's no way for me to achieve anymore, I'd surpassed it. Now, this is going to happen for you too. You're going to have disappointment. And you can let it be the reason why you quit or give up or say that these videos Tom did didn't help me at all. I know you're going to have some challenges. I know you're going to have some disappointment. I know you might have a little bit of a letdown. But also I know you're stronger than any challenge or disappointment. And so what I'm suggesting you do right now, what I'm challenging you to do, is use the challenge, use the disappointment to get even stronger. And anything that happens in life, you can get weaker or stronger. So what are you going to do? On your way to this goal that you're focused on, when something happens you don't like, are you going to complain? Are you going to back up? Are you going to find a way to jump over it or go around it or tunnel under it? Get stronger, get more creative. And look at every disappointment or every challenge that happens to you as a gift. So stay in the game. This video is very important. You might need to come back to this one. Stay in the game. It's not a linear path typically. There's some rocks and some things that you got to get over to achieve your goal. So make sure that you are keeping yourself in the game, canceling the thoughts and the emotions you don't want, and stay true to your outcome 4-3-2-1 so we can keep you on the process. And don't beat yourself up. If it's something you did that you created that was the setback, it's all right. Just correct. Get back on track, okay? So get yourself back on track. Correct the course. As a matter of fact, if you look at an airplane that's going from one destination to another is very rarely on course, truly on course. Most of the time, it's off course. But the pilot is making course corrections throughout, or the automatic pilot with technology today is making course corrections throughout. You've got to make course corrections. You've got to keep yourself on track. You've got to be strong. You've got to notice when you're off track. And rather than beating yourself up, just get back on track. Sounds simple. It's going to take some fortitude. It's going to take some guts. But you've got it. And when you do that, life will look at you differently. Life will look at you and say, oh my gosh, look at the challenge we gave her or him. And look at the way they handled it. Come on. This is a winner. And that's why I want life to look at you as a winner, because I know you are.